Hi, I'm John Green, and this is Crash Course World History. Today we're going to be talking about the California Secession and how it led to the People's Republic of America's declaring war on Mexico and China.
Sir, the magic orb says the Project Razum is ready. Shall we leave?
Let's go.
Let's go.
Now we can go back in time. Thank you, sir. 1962. That was when Trump and Hillary were 16 and 15.
We got it.
Let's go. Blow it!
Good luck, Mr. Whole world is counting.
I got him! Did anyone see that?
Yes!
Mr. Green? Mr. Green, are you there? I think he's dead. Abdul, come quick!
What is the problem?
Sir, John Green is, he was shot.
What? Then who's gonna go stop Donald Trump from becoming president? We have to find a way to stop World War III somehow.
I got it!
We need a volunteer.
Sir, here's your coffee.
No, thank you.
We need you!
You!
You! You to go back in time and save the world!
Who, me? I'm just an IT. Go back in time. We have a time machine? I thought this was a history book company.
This is a history book company, but we also write history itself.
Alright, what do I have to do?
Our main field agent has died. We need you to take over his task. Our objective is to prevent Donald Trump from becoming president by going back in time to 1962, when he was only 16 years old. You need to convince him to become a history teacher instead of a businessman.
Wait, John Green died? How did he die?
Oh, we're not entirely sure, but we just know he was shot. Well, never mind that. Let's just get back to work.
He got shot?
Don't worry about that. I'm sure it was just a small little mistake. You'll be fine. Well, anyways, I'm on my coffee break, so I'm gonna go. Oh, and give him the portal. Put these in a circle and I'll tell you what to do.
Okay. Okay, now what?
Okay, step in the circle and on the count of three, I'll activate it. Ready?
Yeah.
Three!
No! Ah, what the heck, dude? I wasn't even ready.
Okay, so, find a big golden tower. It's Trump's tower.
I still don't see a golden tower. Are you sure this is the right place?
Well, well, well. What do we have here?
What are you doing here, boy?
I'm looking for Mr. Trump's tower.
What? Where are you from, boy? Dublin, Ohio. Union scum.
So once you find the tower, just... Sean? Are you okay? What's happening?
What?
1862?
Oh crap! Abdul, come here quick!
What is it this time, operator?
Sir, I think we sent him back to the wrong time. It says 1862.
What? Then we gotta bring him back!
But sir, the problem is, for the two times the time machine was used, there's a cooldown time. We can't bring him back for another 366 hours and 1 minute. Time machine's rules, not mine.
Then we have to find out where he is. 1862? Isn't that during the American Civil War?
Boy, it's about time you woke up. You've been asleep for about 6 hours.
What? Where am I?
We're in a southern prison camp.
Donald Trump has a prison camp? Never mind.
Anyways, my name's Harry Tubman. I'm a Union spy.
Union spy?
Sean, we kinda sent you to the wrong time. It's 1863. American Civil War.
The Civil War?
Is something wrong?
No, everything's fine. You said you're a Union spy. Are there lots of African-American spies in the South?
Well, there are a couple famous African-American spies around these parts. One of them is my friend, William A. Jackson. He was hired by President Davis to be an undercover spy, posing as a coachman. A servant for Davis, in fact.
Who's Davis?
Jefferson Davis, the Confederate president. He told me how he was able to observe and overhear the Confederate president's discussions with other Confederate leaders, collecting vital intelligence for the Union. I haven't seen him since he ran away last year.
Oh yeah, I think I've heard of him before.
He's in our book, you muppet.
I'm planning on escaping too. I've heard the Union is cooking up some rad colored regiments in Massachusetts.
So there are African American infantries in the Union Army? What about the Confederate African Americans? What do they do?
Well, I've heard that black slaves were more often assigned manual labor and were not as numerous as Union black soldiers. Most of these Confederate blacks were loyal to their masters.
Oh, I guess that makes sense.
However, that doesn't mean that there's widespread acceptance of black soldiers in the North either. Many Northern officers simply didn't believe that blacks could or would fight, so they were often assigned to non-combat positions.
So are you considered a soldier or...?
Well, African-American spies like me are referred to as black dispatches, so technically not soldiers. Keep in mind that African-Americans do more than just fight in the war. We also work in relief roles, such as being nurses, cooks, and blacksmiths.
So what's gonna happen to us now?
Well, black prisoners of war captured by the Confederates face much harsher treatment than the white prisoners of war. But we don't need to worry about that.
Wait, why?
Because we're running away, remember?
Oh yeah, I'll go distract him.
No, wait!
Sean, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Danger, no, no.
Ah! Wait for me!
Hey!
What up? Get back here! We'll be right back.
somewhere else.
Okay, this is the 54th Massachusetts Infantry I was talking about. Let's go.
What are you two doing here?
We're here to see Colonel Shaw.
What for?
We have important information regarding Fort Wagner.
Come with me.
Not you.
Sit down. You must be the reporter from the New York Times.
Yes, I am. I'm here to interview you.
Good. I'm ready when you are.
Okay. Okay, so first off, Mr.
Shaw.
Colonel Shaw. Colonel Shaw. What is your role in the Union Army?
Well, I was a commander of the 54th Massachusetts Infantry Regiment, along with Colonel Edward Holloway.
I understand this is a colored regiment.
Yes, indeed it is. Slaves wanted to enlist in the Union Army, but federal law from 1792 barred them from doing so. But with the escalating number of blacks willing to fight and the declining number of white volunteers, the government reconsidered them.
Also, in 1863, with the Second Confiscation and Militia Act passed by Congress, the government established the Bureau of Colored Troops to manage the black soldiers.
Starting as military leaders, the Union now decided that the African Americans could become frontline soldiers.
What Colonel Shaw does not know is that by the end of the war, there will be 179,000 black men, making up 10% of the Union Army, that have served as soldiers in the U.S. Army, as well as nearly 80 black officers.
Who are you talking to?
So, who helped to start this movement?
Well, Governor John A. Andrew of Massachusetts issued the Civil War's first call for black soldiers. General Benjamin Butler first proposed that the former runaway slaves were contraband.
So what is contraband exactly?
Contraband describes goods or resources that were captured in the war, including property such as slaves. So therefore, they did not need to return them to their former masters, and they could fight in the army. As this happened more and more, slaves started escaping to the north, flooding into the Union. Black soldiers, like the one you met outside, are not treated equally to white soldiers. White soldiers earn $13 a month with an additional $3 clothing allowance, while black soldiers earn $10 a month and have $3 deducted from their earnings for clothing.
Only $10?
There was inflation.
What was that? My 54th and 55th Regiment soldiers began to refuse pay until they were paid equally as their white counterparts. The African-American soldiers then proved their bravery by saving the Union soldiers facing defeat in Louisiana, changing into a victory.
Sean, you can go back now. Go outside. Quick.
Thank you for your time, Colonel Shaw. I have to go.
Go.
Spent a lifetime running, and I always get away. But with you, I'm feeling something that makes me wanna stay. I'm prepared for this. I never shoot to miss, but I feel a storm is coming. If I'm gonna make it through the day, then there's no more use in running. This is something I
shot.
Okay, five.
For a week. I was thinking what to say. Like a week or like 200,000. I was just like 2 months. And like, you know.
462 hours and 46 minutes.
Action.
Problem is what?
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Look at me! Look at me!
You did not get that. You did not.
That's fresh.
Good luck, Mr. Green. The whole world is counting on you.
Okay.
I have crippling depression.
Hi, I'm Peter Sutt. Thank you for watching this episode on history of African Americans in the Civil War. See you next time!